we start everything here at BW, let's start in prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Bless the artists, O God of creation, who by their gifts make this world a more joyful place. Through their labors, they teach us to see more clearly the truth around us. In their inspiration, they call forth wonder and awe in our own living. In their hope and vision, they remind us that life is holy. Bless all who create in your image. Pour your spirit upon them that their hearts may sing and their work be fulfilling. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And I'm going to introduce to you our art teacher, Ms. Erica Fabrizio, to tell us about Rocky.
Thank you. mother died of cancer. It was really sad. I moved to Madrid to study at the School of Fine Arts. I studied cubism, which are little cubes in my paintings. I had quite a reputation of being unusual. I was expelled from school because I didn't want to take the last test, just because. I joined the Surrealism group in Paris. Surrealism is dreamlike images in my paintings. I like to use oil paints on canvas and wood. My most famous painting is The Persistence of Memory. Most people know it as a melting clock. I married my wife Gala and moved to the US to escape World War II. My wife believed in me more than anyone. A lot, actually. She would take my paintings down the streets and run down. Would anybody like to buy my husband's paintings? Though some people thought it was impressive and odd. When I returned home after 2 years, I got very interested in math, science, and DNA in my art. I hope my legacy in the art world is that people can paint what they dream and what makes them happy. I say that because I would fall asleep with keys in my hands and put it on the floor. I would drop the keys once I fell asleep and would hit the plate. I would wake up and paint whatever I dreamed. I died of heart failure January 23rd, 1989. I was 84 years old. I'm buried in a museum in Spain.
Scholarships and my own savings, I got into a fine arts program at Philippian School of Design for Women. There I focused on portraits and still life. I later married Carlos and Cleese. Later we had our first child, who died of diphtheria, the same disease that killed my brother. I made many portraits of people in need, so people will know about us and hopefully help them. I made art about the things around me and the people closest to me. I made a studio where I painted portraits. Towards the end of the 1960s, when the first woman rights were made, I was recognized as a feminist. I was more famous than ever. I made my first self-portrait at the age of 80. I painted many portraits of people like Andy Warhol. My famous saying is, save the best for last. I died on October 13, 1984, at the age of 80. Thank you.
On the 9th of October, there was a lady lying just in the wall. On the 25th, there was a man sitting in the bar. On the 9th of October, there was artist in Japan. On the 25th, most famous living artist in the world. I have created number 5,901 support. One of my most expensive art pieces in the soul for the world. Los Angeles. About Oscar nomination, which
2010. And I reportedly told my mother that my job was being a house painter. I was once in a Britain-based gang, and I compiled in a book called World and Peace. In 2007, I won Art's Greatest Living Britain Award. However, I didn't take the piece in person, wishing to keep my identity a secret.
Buried in the cemetery in France. grade, I caught liver disease, causing my left hepatic lymph symptoms rising fiercely and well, I'm coming from my disease, and my mom, artist, taught me how to draw and paint. I'm a very shiny, quiet child, but I also love photography, games, and sports. I graduated from Carnegie Institute of Technology in 1949, leaving a degree of couture design shortly after. I traveled to New York, where I worked as a commercial illustrator for about 10 years, and I loved the job. I began painting in the late 1950s, where I visited Kinto's and Pants, Coca-Cola bottles, and wooden replicas of silver hat boxes. By 1963, I was mass producing purposely watered-down six-foot paintings, lilies, and cards. I then began printing endless courses, lilies, and garish colors using silkscreen. Some of the most notable artwork include many 1960s garish pocket paintings of consumer goods, mostly being Kinto's and Pants and such. I use a silkscreen technique. I took a photograph. Silkscreen was used by many mass-producing companies in the late 1950s, using it to advertise their products. My work was heavily inspired by American celebrity culture, Los Angeles, beauty, and plastic. I like things that change quickly. Many artists do not openly admit they painted their dreams for fame and money, but I, in many interviews, said that I was doing what I was doing for the fame and money. I'd always like fame, inspired by celebrities and such. I made my work in my studio in New York, The Factory. It became a well-known gathering place for Hollywood celebrities, wealthy patrons, and self-proclaimed smart people, and many more social curiosities. In the late 1960s, I managed experimental work at the Vez Underground, and founded a magazine called Interview, and also authored many books. Let's just say, I was a very multi-talented person. Sadly, in 1986, I caught liver disease, causing me to die.
Thank you.
created to represent my mother, as spiders are often seen as clever and in some ways protectors from annoying and sometimes deadly nuisances. I wear a beret, I have long hair, my favorite color is red, and I died May 31st, 2010 at the age of 90.
Turpentine, canvas, brushes, pastel knife, and BB soap. Here are some fun facts about myself. I painted almost 900 paintings in 10 years. I live with mental illness, and I also painted some very good paintings over the years. My most famous was Starry Night and My Sunflowers. I only sold one painting when I was alive. I am famous for my unique color and brushwork. I also painted people and landscapes. I am known for cutting off my ear, and I was nicknamed the Red-Headed Madman. There are a few more facts about my life. Three women did not accept my marriage proposal. Theo named his child after me. My brother Theo named his child after me. I was the second child to my mother named Vincent. The first one died. I got some inspiration for Starry Night and Real Life. I painted Starry Night when I was in the hospital with my mental illness. And I looked out the window and I saw beautiful stars and towers, so I painted back. I was painting a painting and I loved it so much that I kept it. And people wanted it, but I did not give it to them. I died at 37 on July 29, 1890 from a gunshot wound. So my life is pretty crazy, wacky, sad, and fun. I once said, I dream my painting, and I paint my dreams. I hope you enjoyed the facts about me, and I hope you have a good day.